Ladies and gentlemen, this special added attraction, a main event anywhere in the world, but right here in Carrollton, Georgia tonight. One fall, 1 hour time limit. Introducing first of all in the ring, he is from Bucksnort, Tennessee. He weighs in at 235 pounds. Bunkhouse Buck. His opponent making his way to the ring from Stone Mountain, Georgia. He weighs in at 252 pounds. Welcome to Carrollton, Georgia, Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake Roberts. One fall, 1 hour time limit.
You know, Bobby, it wasn't too long ago, I was just doing an interview here with Jimmy Golden, and all of a sudden he comes back, he's got a beard, dressed up like Festus, and now he's Bunkhouse Buck. What is this all about? He acts like this is two different people.
Tends to lead a little bit toward the bipolar theory. I don't know if you ever really know who you're talking to.
I think he's got a problem. There's something definitely wrong with him. We're being joined here by Doug Summers. Doug, I know you've been around this business for a long time. I was interviewing this man. He was Jimmy Golden. All of a sudden, he's Bunkhouse Buck. I mean, how do you explain something like that?
Well, all I can say is Jimmy Golden is probably showing a lot of yellow. Jake the Snake is a mean character. I know why he isn't in the ring. He's scared.
So I guess we're seeing the tougher of two evils, maybe? Is that what we're talking about here?
We're talking about being scared. He's in the ring with Snake. He doesn't want to be in the ring with Snake, especially that little thing he's got in that bag.
Well, he was telling me earlier that he was scared to death of snakes, you know, and then he comes out with this second nature character. I mean,
Well, let me tell you, would you get in the ring if you had a snake in the bag?
No, I would not.
Well, there you go. I wouldn't either.
Well, Bobby, what are we seeing here? Nice arm bar. All right, we got a reversal now. Jake cuts him off. Oh, he went for the DDT, early. He went for the DDT real early in this match.
Everybody knows when you go for that move what's coming. You better move quick or you're going to fall to a very deadly hold.
That's right. You know, Jake Roberts looks good. I mean, he's dropped about 30 pounds. I mean, he looks like he's ready. You know, he was talking about getting a title shot. I know you've been wanting a title shot. But let me ask you real quickly before we get it back in this match while we have a little chance here. What is your problem with Timms Jr.? I mean, is this thing going to be settled? Is it settled now?
I'm going to tell you right now, next show in Carrollton, I'm going to give you the biggest shock in the world about Ken Timms and Doug Summers.
All right, there you have it.
The fans here definitely behind Jake Roberts in this match, calling for the DDT, and he was very close to landing that rock. It was almost over, but Bunkhouse Buck was a little too quick still.
Well, he's back to the left arm again, and oh, another reversal. Oh, nice hip toss.
Almost got it again.
You know what happens when he drops that DDT? It's just a matter of time, and then you're going to see that snake.
It's all over but that crime because he may let him slip twice. That third time, he's going to clock him, and then you're going to see the snake crawl all over him.
I think you're right, Doug. I tell you, Bobby, this thing, you know, we're taking this to another level now. All-Star Championship Wrestling, you saw a lot of good regular old-style wrestling. But then you see this interference, the six-man thing we got coming up. We got all kinds of things going on. Now we got a snake out here, and we got a guy who has two personalities. I mean, what else more can you ask for?
Not only does he have two personalities, he's one of the top wrestlers in the world today.
And, yes, he is. And very, very good wrestler.
No matter how quirky he is, he backs up everything he says and everything he does by that wrestling ability.
The Snake Man is as snaky and sneaky as that little critter in the bag. Don't underestimate the snake. He's been around a long time. He knows how to fight dirty and get dirty. And when it comes to getting dirty, he can play the best game.
Right now, a couple punches. He's going to shoot Bunkhouse into the corner. Oh, we call it big knee. And that rocked him, Bobby.
Bunkhouse Buck using a shortcut now. He seems to...
Well, he's taking advantage of that five count, Bobby. And that's smart. That's smart if you're trying to beat a man. That's...
Once he saw that opening, those cat-like reflexes, he jumped right on top of Jake. And he's trying his best to cut that airflow off.
Well, he's got the snake down. He better take advantage of it and get dirty, or he's going to get a real bad wake-up call in a minute. When you got a man down on the ropes, you get real dirty, real nasty, real quick. Anything goes when you got him on the ropes and on the floor.
Well, he's got those cowboy boots, I believe, for the heel on him, Aaron. He's putting it in Roberts' face. Roberts, right now, is kind of sucking for air.
He may be sucking for air, but he better start getting on, Snake, because when he starts sucking for air, he's thinking. And when he starts thinking, he gets real dangerous.
Yeah, you got a good point there. Oh, he almost hit the rough. That would have been the end real quick.
Throwing those punches, he can't see. Jake's Bunkhouse Buck has used raking the eyes to his advantage. Now he's got Jake tied up in the ropes. Lefts and rights to the side of the head.
Four big punches there, and I'll tell you what, Roberts is in trouble.
He's in trouble, but he better start punching more and kicking. Take him down. This is where you hurt the man. Don't give up on a man in the ropes.
You know, I was trying to talk to him there, Bobby and Doug. I'm telling you, something about Golden that just ain't right. I mean, there's something about Golden that just ain't right. There's something wrong with him. I call him Golden because that's who he was 10 minutes ago. And he goes back in the locker room and comes out with this outfit. Got a, I don't know how he got the beard. He's got a beard. He didn't have that earlier. And he's wrestling like Jimmy Golden to a degree with a sort of a, I guess, a roughhouse style, if you will.
He has that, I don't know, I believe he has a short fuse. There's just, you're right, there's something not right there. And he's...
Now, you see how he's using the ropes? He's using the ropes at advantage when the referee can't see. And that's the best way to get a man down, because you can't call what you can't see. That's exactly what I would do against the Snake Man if I was in the ring.
Very dangerous, you're right. You gotta stay on him. And so far, he's done a pretty good job of doing that. I think,
Well, if the Snake Man don't start getting up and fighting back, he's gonna be in real bad trouble. And that snake in that bag ain't gonna help him.
You know, Doug, I'm like 6'3", and I was standing beside Roberts, and he's like 2-3 inches taller than me. He's a big man.
Yes,
and Golden's a big man. Golden, it's hard to tell when you're looking on TV, but Golden's like 6'4", 240 pounds. It's all lean muscle, like the Great Dane type muscle, like the Armstrong. And he throws those punches in there, and he's taking several of them to the head now.
That's right. When you start punching and kicking, it starts wearing your body down. And when you wear that body down, that man is getting beat up, is starting to lose it. He forgets where he's at. And if Snake don't come around, Roberts is going to have a bad time in the ring. His brain's going to start closing down, and the man on top is going to pin him. You see, he's got a headlock. He's squeezing the breath out of him. He's making him turn red in the ring. He's cutting his breathing off. He's got to start fighting back, or he's going to be in real bad trouble here in a second.
Well, I'll tell you, Roberts looks better than he did, what, Bobby, about the last 10 years. I mean, he looks great. Looks like he's ready to try to be a top contender. And he's having a rough time of it right now.
Both guys in tremendous shape and great wrestling ability between the two of them. And
Bunkhouse is taking every shortcut he can.
Well, right now he's taking away his breathing and he can't move. When you get a man down on the mat with a front face lock, or a headlock and start squeezing around the throat, you can't think and you can't breathe. You got 240 pounds on top of you. It's kind of hard to push up and get up.
This might be it right here. One more time, it's over. No, Roberts pulled his hand up.
The crowd definitely getting behind Jake Roberts.
You see now, he's getting the people behind him, and I don't think that's right. I think the people need to be quiet out there and let the man wrestle. That just gives the man more courage to get up and go.
Oh, reversal.
That's your jaw, a jawbreaker. Now let's set his head up a little bit. Now he's going to shake the cobwebs out. He better watch out. He needs to attack him. You see how
three big punches.
He's throwing punches. That's not legal.
Well, Buckhouse don't know where he is. He's begging for mercy on that.
He's in trouble.
Oh, nice short arm clothesline. He's got this place rocking.
He's got motivation going for him now. There he goes. Nope, he missed again. Hook on the rope. Roberts in trouble. In the back.
Referee did not see that.
The referee did not see what you don't see.
Oh, wait a minute. What we got here? Well, we don't have instant replay in wrestling here. I mean, that's...
What right does that referee have to come down here and tell him he lost? Now see, there comes the snake. I'd be on ringing for kid.
What in the world just happened?
He gave the referee what he deserved, the snake.
Bobby, you want to go down there and talk to Jake? Let's see what happened here.
You see how fast that ring clears when that big bad snake gets out?
All I know is, I'll tell you what, that referee ate that snake for lunch. Well, he's saying both men are disqualified. We have a double DQ.
The referee has disqualified both contestants in this match, a double disqualification.